Alright, so here we are. You can see on the Pelican I've added some turquoise. It's multicolored turquoise. Here we still have the black and a bit of tank brown to the very front here, and some red. It's Mephiston red. One of the new game's special colors.
And the tank brown, we found that it's started to be called armor brown, is that right?
Yeah, true. Yeah.
And that's from Model Air.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you're looking for it, there may be somewhere that has old stock and it's tank brown, but they've actually changed it to armor brown now. But yeah. Ben's been using it so prolifically that it's now just ingrained to say tank brown.
We start with the turquoise and some black to create a somewhat dark sea blue-like color, one of my favorite colors. And the nice thing if you mix it from turquoise and black is that you can actually decide on your own how saturated the color will be in the end. Because you can vary with the amount of blue. So that should be a nice color to start with. Rather dark. And just to make it a tiny bit brighter, I will add a bit of white. But still rather dark. And then you just have to decide actually which panels you would like to have in a different color. You could go directly for the scheme from the movie, or be a bit more free on that. We'll try to be close to the original.
And this is because even though these are officially licensed, certain manufacturers have done them like slightly different ways.
Yeah. And regarding the look I want to achieve is I want to have these plates look like they've been initially from that white material, and the blue paint is just one additional layer of paint, and it's been chipped off at the edges. So I try to stipple more.
So not in terms of like with pointism, you're doing very tiny dots. You're stippling it, but the marks still touch each other, but you get that slightly patchy effect.
Yeah.
And you're doing it deliberately because that, okay. So if you don't know what this term is, stippling is just where you're placing very small touches of the brush onto the figure, and keeping that area close together. So it when you hold the model away, it gives that kind of blurred effect. Would you say that's true?
Mm-hmm.
Maybe the master painter might have a couple of comments on stippling.
I think the stippling is quite nice to use it also if you have maybe a not so clean line from the transition that you have, to just you basically just do little dots like that on the surface.
Mm-hmm.
And it's good to break up lines that you've created previously, but also to create a effect like that with two layers of paint. I also do a lot of my weathering work actually like that. So it's really nice to get that multi-layer of paint look to a surface, because you have, in the end, it looks like you have little chunks of paint still on the sticking to the surface, and others have been ripped away. And it's nice because it introduces another texture as well to the whole surface.
And of it's, would you say it's a lot like when you're doing the thin layers with your blending to stop, let it dry? You may think, what have I done here? This doesn't look right, but you're going to be doing a slight wash of the strong tone in order to tie it to the rest of the model,
mm-hmm.
right? So that that will smooth it out, so to speak, and it won't look, you know, it's not going to look terrible. It will all blend in with the rest of the model.
Yeah, that's also important to continue with washes over it, or in that scale, it's not that important, but in a larger scale, to really also paint highlights on that to make it look more 3D. So you would highlight it actually like scratches or something similar. In that scale, we shouldn't actually highlight it too much because that would look a bit off in scale. Otherwise, right. These dents would be very, very deep and that would just look strange. So for this year, is okay like that.
Actually, just coming back to that plate, it's like you've left some of the white, so you've not quite done all of it. Is that mm-hmm. right?
Yeah. I want, especially around the edges of the panel, I want it to be more scraped off.
Right.
So I'll do the same here on the second one.
That's because you were when we talked off cam, it depends on what material you're trying to represent.
Yeah.
So you wanted it to be as if this is the color of the Falcon that the blue was actually sprayed on.
Mm-hmm.
So it would have that chipping effect. If say the whole plate was made out of a material that was completely blue, you would do it in a slightly different way.
Yeah, definitely. Then I would show the material that is exposed underneath. So maybe like rusted, oxidated metal or a dark color.
Right.
But I would show. I would always try to have like that little separation here to the edge to make it like look like a second layer of coat of paint.
Okay.
And I tried to get the paint like more solid to the back of the model and like it would be naturally shipped off from the sides. You have to be careful that when you decided to go for the stippling technique that you're actually not using too thin color because you don't want the underlying color to really shine through. Because the paint would not really be rubbed off like that. It more flakes off.
Especially space paint.
Yeah,
that stuff's going to be pretty tough, right?
Yeah, do your research on space paint. No, just kidding. But you will find actually a lot of references for weathered material or weathered cars. So if you're not sure of how you want to approach something like that, also just go and check your references.
Mm. Actually, for you guys at home, Ben actually has in front of him some screenshots of the Millennium Falcon that he's just printed off on the computer to have. If you was doing this at home, I imagine you could just have your laptop sitting there, but for the way that the studio is set up. So he has the images of the Millennium Falcon in front of him, so he can have that reference point of where to put the blue panels, and to have that reference of when to stop, so it doesn't look too busy with the different panels.
Yeah.
Would you agree with that, mate? Because you started to smile there as if I was just talking total garbage.
No. It's good. I thought if you mentioned that, I have the reference here and I'm not hitting the exact place, spots here. People are like, okay, what's wrong with him? But
we all the different pictures you were looking at, there were different versions.
There were quite a few versions actually also on different official models. So it was kind of surprising for us as well. Plates are not the exact same as on the reference, so I'm still going a bit freehand,
yeah.
Freestyle on that. Here you can see I've just painted the lower part of this plate here, and I will add some red to the upper part. We'll mix some of the Mephiston red with a bit of the tank brown.
Would you say you're putting a tip of the red into the brown, or a tip of the brown into the red?
Half-half.
Oh, okay. My God, that's a recipe from Ben Komets on paint. this is a first, people.
When you paint something like that, make really sure to hit the area just next to that tube here to make elements like the tube stand out a bit more. And also the paint would not really be chipped off because it's kind of protected by that tube.
It's amazing how just adding those little areas of colour is really starting to bring it to life. I mean, before, yeah, it's a really cool effect, and I was really drooling over this thing off camera, but... It really breaks it up a bit more and just starts to come a bit more alive.
Yeah, I agree, and I think this also makes a huge difference actually to the pre-painted model when you pay more attention now to in that stage here. You can really make it pop out and stand out.
And so, for example, when you were mixing the turquoise with the black and then added that tiny tip of white to brighten it, you can tailor this to the effects that you want. It's say like with your, I don't know, say for example, the favorite faction of your army might have a specific set color, but one painter might do that type of color slightly differently to another painter. Yeah. So you can really make it your own.
And I think that's also one point where I don't like to really give like recipes for everything, because I want people to find their own colors and experiment on their own. It would be so boring, you know, if all the non-metal gold in the world would look the same.
Right.
So, yeah, just be free and play with that a little. So, yeah, I think you understand how that is applied now. I will continue and pick out other elements in the blue and the red, and we'll be back for showing you how to glaze these down and also add additional weathering to the other plates.
Awesome.
Great. All right, so you can see I've continued with the colored patches over here and there, also here on the top, and I've also just quickly painted this window here. Basically just using black and a bit of gloss varnish without doing any transition work. Also remember the turrets will be placed just over that, so we will hardly see any of that. But to show you how I did that, we left this here to still do it on cam.
Just sorry to come quickly back to the blue. I think it's worth mentioning how you've been quite withheld, you know what I mean? You haven't done loads of patches of blue all over the place, almost the suggestion of it.
Yeah, I just made sure that it looked balanced to me, so I couldn't really check on these areas here from the picture I found on the internet, so I just went freestyle on that just to make it somewhat balanced on the model.
And now you're just using some pure black?
Yeah.
Thinned. Just making sure you've got a really good brush with a nice tip, so you don't go over and then have to repaint the light areas, because repainting light colors over like a dark mistake is quite difficult.
Yeah, but we also haven't really done the top highlight, so here on that area, so I think that's also good to have in mind that you do the black and also the gloss varnish first and then do the correction of the highlight.
Just just in case there is a small stake.
Yeah, because especially with these small elements here, you will touch the sides for sure. Okay, so quick and easy, just a thin coat of black. But make sure that the coat is thick enough to actually cover with one go, because you don't want to retouch it several times.
And also, contrarily, you don't want it too thin that it kind of moves everywhere all over the figure and then starts to slip other sides.
Mm-hmm. For the next step, I will take some gloss varnish. I'll take some of the Games Workshop gloss varnish. I usually work also with the gloss varnish from Model Color. It works also quite nice. Here the gloss varnish is just fine. We just want to have a bit of gloss in there.
Would you say it's fair that for something when you've got like a really small area like this to actually have something like the Games Workshop varnish, because you can just pop open the lid and take it straight from there, whereas with the Vallejo dropper bottles you really have to pour some out. So you might maybe, if you typically do use a lot of it, large areas, maybe get the Vallejo stuff, but if you just do tiny little areas like this, maybe get something like the Games Workshop, because it's just easier to take little bits out of.
Yeah, plus it just depends on what kind of paints you have at home and what is lying around.
Right.
Just
so it's not that you specifically say this is the best for gloss varnish. There's loads of gloss varnishes out there. Just get a gloss varnish.
Yeah. So you see the effect is quite nice. The gloss varnish. It's already dry, but you have that nice, not really ultra glossy, but.
It's making the light actually work for you.
Yeah.
Because even something we were saying off camera, like sometimes if you were to paint a tabletop figure in completely in non-metallic metal, maybe you look at it from the table from that weird angle, that one angle where it just looks wrong because of you have to paint that forced perspective of light.
Yeah.
Whereas with something like this, wherever it turns on the table, it will have the natural effect of the way the light hits.
Yeah, you just have to be careful that you don't end up with a model that looks like covered in grease. Mm-hmm. So you need to still apply it just in certain areas. So now I'm just taking some of that highlight color.
That's the kind of base tone, the gray and the white.
Yeah, with a bit of the strong tone. A bit more of the strong tone to the sides.
Clear Bay 327. We're opening the magnetic field.
It's a bit brighter here on the top. All right, and yeah, that's actually the fast trick to get nice looking windows here for our Millennium Falcon. In the next chapter, we will.
Wait, Millennium Falcon? I thought it was the Enterprise.
So in the next chapter, we will focus on these vents here and how to achieve a nice little weathering effect from those. Okay.
Awesome.
คนรุ่นใหม่จากทั่วทุกคนแห่งในโลกร่วมแรงกันสู้เพื่ออนาคต
ฉันทำตามหน้าที่ของฉัน
ผมทำหน้าที่ของผมผมทำหน้าที่ของผมฮะ
ผมก็ทำหน้าที่ของผมครับ
พวกเขาทำหน้าที่ของเขาแล้วคุณล่ะร่วมกองพลฐานราบเคลื่อนที่กู้โลกกองทัพรับประกันความเป็นพลเมือง